Hi everyone, I'm Renée van der Avoird, Assistant Curator of Canadian Art at the Art Gallery of Ontario. Welcome to our close-looking series of talks in which we focus on one work from the Art Gallery of Ontario's collection. I'm joining you today from the territory of the Anishinaabe, the Mississaugas of the New Credit, the Haudenosaunee, and the Wendat peoples. I'm grateful to be able to live and work here on this land. Today, the artwork we are looking at is Hey, Hey, Paula, a major installation by Toronto artist Sarindar Dhaliwal, purchased by the AGO just last year. We are featuring this work in the context of our spring theme, which is portraits of resilience. This is perhaps the work in the AGO's collection that contains the most portraits. Here, 600 photographic portraits are installed in a monumental grid that runs about 65 feet long. The installation is immersive. You walk in and you feel completely bombarded by a sea of anonymous smiling faces that extend beyond your field of vision. You are invited to pick up a red rotary telephone on a small red nightstand, which plays a 1960s ballad called Hey Paula by the duo Paul and Paula. The artist appropriated the portraits from the New York Sunday Times engagement announcement section between 1989 and 1992. Each is a studio portrait of a young woman who is about to be married. The artist has omitted her name, her family, and her affiliations, thus rendering each of the women anonymous. There is an uncanny uniformity to this group of women. They are almost all white. Almost all of them are wearing a pearl necklace, which is a symbol of innocence, purity, propriety, and wealth. Sarindar learned that the pearl necklaces also contain secret codes. The size, the shape, or the rarity of a pearl can indicate just how much that necklace cost. Sarindar was fascinated by the secret code and by reading these women's lineages and social and professional connections in the captions that accompanied these photographs. The fact that this information was listed in the newspaper made her think of a Western parallel to the South Asian practice of arranged marriages. Marriages which are often for status and power as much as, or perhaps even more than, for love. This anthropological angle adds a poignant element of social commentary to this work. Together, the portraits are a study of conformity. Their seriality and their placement in a grid hints at the patriarchal positioning of women within structures of marriage and family. Sarindar printed each of these images on glossy 8x10-inch paper, and they're hung with pink map tacks in the four corners of each photograph. And I think you can see that here in this detail. From the very small halftone thumbnails that the artist clipped from the newspaper, she then enlarged those images and printed them by hand, changing the color filter to this very intense red that you see. The translation of each image from the small thumbnail to this new format turns the faces into an array of dots and smudges, omitting the finer details of the women's features. Through this intervention or this act of translation, viewers may begin to wonder who these women were, who they might be today, and if they ended up happy in their marriages, and if indeed their marriages have lasted. When seen from afar, this installation becomes a homogeneous field of red. And if you're familiar with Sarindar's work, you'll know that she has this really profound love for color. In a recent interview, she mentioned that as a child, she was inspired by her mother's clothing, which was very vibrant. Sarindar also started her creative career at the age of 18 as a weaver, and she learned to dye textiles with natural materials like daffodil and onion skins. And her interest in color started, you know, at this early age and really is manifest in almost all of the work she has made ever since. Here you can see the walls are painted black. The installation's ambiance is that of a private space, you know, perhaps a darkened bedroom, evocative of the romantic fantasies one might have as a teenager. So this could be, you know, the private world of a young person in a state of longing, waiting by the phone. As I mentioned, when visitors pick up the receiver, the song Hey Paula plays in their ear. I won't play it for you now. I want to keep a bit of surprise for when we install this work and you can come visit. But here are some images of the music video to give you an idea. The song is about falling in love and getting married after graduating from school. It evokes that classic kind of fairy tale myth of Western romantic love that really reinforces dominant narratives of heterosexuality and monogamy. The pairing of this ballad with the sea of red portraits creates a sense of irony or satire. And I like to point out the kind of grid of rectangular forms in the music video that is kind of a coincidental resonance with Sarindar's installation. In Hey Hey Paula, the ironic combination of elements, you know, the photographs, the ballad, the telephone, suggests that romantic love has traditionally been a socially acceptable conduit for female desire and really a way to contain or to control it. And this is a notion that the artist really contends with, not only in this work, but throughout her practice. Sarindar's work always has a link to the personal. And here, it draws on her experience of having to negotiate that tension between assimilation and independence as someone who has lived in India, the UK, and Canada, and has a hybridized identity. As part of her lived experience, Sarindar has had to choose between prescribed paths and personal agency. And this work really brings those tensions from her personal life onto a broader platform and acknowledges that the constructs that seek to define a woman extend beyond place and time, and they really do persist across geographies and generations and cultures. Sarindar Dhaliwal has been creating work since the 80s. She has produced a very rich and cohesive body of work, and she works in a range of media, not only installation, but also video, photography, drawing, painting. Her work has been exhibited widely across Canada and internationally, and generally her work deals with ideas of memory, identity, and migration. And they're all tied together by, again, her signature use of intense color and really rich, compelling imagery. In June of last year, the AGO interviewed Sarindar as part of our virtual Art in the Spotlight series. And I urge you to listen to that interview for more information on Sarindar's works, as well as her full biography. Thank you so much for joining us today. And I do hope you'll be able to visit soon. Thank you and take care.